For the past 9 months that I've been a senior, I've spent almost every night staring at this document just like this. I tried a few ideas that I thought would be interesting or would at least make sense as my last lecture, but I've always come back to an empty page with these angry, bold letters staring back at me. I wanted this to be perfect. I wanted this to be my magnum opus, my coup de grace, my piece de resistance. But I didn't know how to show it all in video form. So I just decided to start from the beginning, where it all started. Where nothing was everything, where everything was nothing. Okay, maybe we don't start at that beginning. My beginning. It was the best of times, it was the worst of times. The best of times being where I become who I am today, the worst of times being the part when I go. We'll get to that. This is Eudora High School, where it all began. I can safely say that these have been the best 4 years of my life. I knew right from the start that I wanted to be a part of two fantastic groups here in Eudora. I wanted to sing with the big kids in the select choirs, and I wanted to make some really cool videos with some really cool people. Choir was always something that I went into thinking it was just for fun. I liked reading music, I liked singing in the shower, so why don't I just audition? Little did I know that I'd be staying in the same choir for the next 4 years, and then minoring in choral music. Ever since I've been here, I knew I've wanted to be in video too specifically. Watching those kids run around the halls with their camera bags and their boom poles, and a tall, bald, middle-aged man leading the pack, I knew that was my calling. Rob, you have a gift. You take an already pretty interesting hobby and make it so much more interesting just by being you. Sometimes I like to think that people take your class just because they like being around you, because you're just such a likable person. I don't think I'd ever be this interested in video if it wasn't for your crazy personality or your genuine love and appreciation for film. You've been one of my biggest mentors, and I can't thank you enough for that. I'm gonna miss your bald head.
Go!
was pretty easy for some people. Just go up to someone and talk to them. For others, like me, it's like asking them to do the impossible. So for the most part, I kept to myself, or next to this person right here. It stayed like that for a while, and it really affected me in a bad way, especially during junior year when everyone was equally as depressed. I thought I'd be one of those kids that just kind of floated and didn't really have a friend group to rely on, and that really bothered me. So I did something about it. I let my guard down, and I made some friends. And I'm so glad that I did. I love all of you guys. Each one of you are so unique and special to me, and I'm so sad to see some of you go so far away. For some, we'll be a lot closer than we'd like. For others, halfway across the country. You guys mean so much to me, and I'm so glad that I met every single one of you. I hope you like my letter. These are the Orrs. We're an average family, we do average things, we live in an average house, and drive average cars. We're average, at least to others. To me, my family is everything. My dad is the funniest guy I know, period. Even if I say your jokes are horrible, they're not. I just don't want to admit that you're funny. I aspire to have an ounce of your patience. It's insane how you deal with me sometimes. I like to think that my mom is my enemy sometimes, because we argue a lot, like any mother and daughter would. I think that's good though. You taught me to not back down from a challenge and to put myself out there. My mom is one of the most hardworking people I know. I can remember going to all of your races when I was little, and screaming my throat out watching you reach the finish line. You never quit. I love you for that. My brothers, Truman and Pullen, you guys annoy the hell out of me sometimes, but that's what siblings are for. Truman, you and I don't talk much, but that's okay. We're both kind of introverted people. You're the one that really got me interested in video at first. Pullen, don't stop being yourself. You're so incredibly humiliating to be around sometimes, but who isn't when they're 11? You're a pretty awesome person, dude. I know your rapping career will take off when you're older. And finally, my kid sister, Lainey Marie. Lainey, for as long as I've known you, you've been one of the most unique people I've ever had the pleasure of calling my sister. I love your awkwardness and I love your humor. You and I butt heads a lot at home, and I don't think that will ever stop. But we're sisters, and that's what sisters do. Lainey, I have a few regrets, and one of those is not being the best big sister to you. I didn't get to paint your nails, or lend you clothes, or do your hair, because as far as I'm aware, any kind of skin-to-skin contact from me means death to you. Let me at least tell you these things. You are so kind. You are so smart. You are so, so beautiful. And I love you so much. Never change. 14-year-old me would probably be so shocked to hear about all the things that I got up to in the past 4 years of being here. Coming into high school, I knew I wouldn't be as involved as some of the other kids were, just because, like most kids at age 14, I suffered from a lot of social anxiety. It was mainly due to the fact that I was so unbelievably afraid of being myself around other people. I never really showed this side of myself to anyone else besides my family. I was so scared of what other people would think of me. This stuck with me for the past 3 years until I realized I was really tired of doing all this work for literally no reason. I've learned a lot since being here, and I've changed a lot too, thank God. I learned how to sing better in choir. I learned how to shoot and edit really dope videos in video too. I learned so much from all of my friends, mostly unhelpful, but sometimes a little helpful. I learned how to master patience from my dad and how to fight for what I believe in from my mom and from my siblings. I learned how to be the best sister this whole world has ever seen. And from myself, I learned how to love myself. It's not all the way there yet, but I'm trying. At least I can say that I'm proud of who I am today. That I really wanted to get across with this last lecture is that it's okay to be yourself. I put a lot of me into this video, which kind of really scares me because I'm still trying to learn how to just not care anymore. So as much as this last lecture is for my school, my friends, and my family, it's for me too. A reminder, be yourself. Because no one genuinely gives a damn. And it's fine. Everything's fine. I'm so proud of what I've done and who I've become while attending this school and meeting all my friends and growing up with the class of 2022. It's genuinely been fun. As much as I'd like to say that I would 100% do it all over again, I absolutely would not, and I cannot wait to graduate as soon as possible. So, thanks for the memories, Eudora High School, but I think I'm ready to do the skedaddle.
Black. They laid the label down on its back for just one stardust stone, sleeping in somewhere down the road.